friends, this week we are talking about another element of art, and that is shape. Earlier in our lesson, we read a biography about our mentor artist for this week, Henri Matisse. And we learned that later in life, Henri Matisse used paper and glue and scissors to kind of create these beautiful, intricate shapes that he used in his artwork. And there are examples of that in the lesson as well if you want to take a look. So let's move on to our art project involving shapes this week. So to get started, we're going to need some paper. Okay? I've chosen to use colored paper this week, but if you don't have any construction paper or colorful paper at home, that's okay. Henri Matisse didn't either. He had his assistants paint his paper before he cut it, and you can do that too. If you don't have paint, you can use crayons or colored pencils or markers or whatever you have. You are the artist in charge, so you do what you would like. I'm also choosing a piece of neutral paper as my background. This week, I think I'm going to use white because it shows up really well on my camera. But you can use black or brown or whatever you would like to see, but just some neutral color so that our colors really pop on the paper, okay? You're also going to need to use some scissors and a glue stick or a glue bottle, whatever you have handy. Tape will even work in a pinch. Whatever you've got at home works well. You're also going to need a pencil in case you want to trace your shapes before cutting. Okay? All right. So let's get going. Before any artist begins a piece, there's some amount of planning. Okay? We've talked about color a lot in art class. We've talked about primary colors, which are red, yellow, and blue. We've talked about secondary colors, which are orange, green, and violet. We've talked about complementary colors, which are when colors are opposite ends on the color wheel. We've also talked about analogous colors. Remember, analogous colors are three colors that are next to each other on the color wheel. Now, I have been on a really big analogous color kick lately. So I've chosen these three colors to help me out. Violet, red violet, and a kind of magenta color is my inspiration. These three colors here. Okay? I also wanted to choose a piece of color that's really going to pop. I want that to be noticeable. So I chose yellow as that color. So this is kind of a family of violet, and the complementary color to violet is yellow. Okay? But you use whatever colors you'd like to see as well. This was just something that I wanted to use in my piece today. Okay? So now that we have our color scheme picked out, it's time to get started. You can look at the mentor pieces in the read aloud for Henri and seeing how he used all these flowing shapes of like flowers and ferns and birds. Or you can look at some of the pieces I included in the lesson. He cut out squares and triangles and placed them on the paper. I'm gonna get started by just tracing out a few designs on my paper, just to kind of help me out before I cut. So whenever you're ready, let's get started. Okay, so I took a break from the camera to just quickly draw some shapes that I noticed in some of Henri Matisse's work, but I also included some of my own. I just drew some quick squares. I drew a squiggly bird. You know, kind of looks like a bird. I drew some rhombuses and some kind of fruit. It kind of looks like an apple to me a little bit. I don't know. I wanted it to be a fruit. Then I drew some really wavy plants and some stars. I really loved the stars in our mentor text. from Henry Scissors. So I wanted to include some stars in my work this week as well. So take some time, kind of draw some shapes. I'm probably going to spend some time cutting shapes, just guessing, because I don't want to stress. I think art should be really relaxing and fun. And so it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect, because there's no mistakes in art, only happy accidents. So I am going to take my scissors and start to cut out my shapes.
Under a pale blue sky, you never felt so cold. Another sleepless night, how could you ever let go? How do you recognize the dirty face of gold behind that crooked line where you never knew you'd go? Headed for the open door.
So now I have everything kind of laid out the way I want it. I wanted to create a sense of movement with my lines here, and with like my bird and the stars and the earth below, maybe. It's kind of abstract, but I really like it. So now I'm going to use my glue, and I'm going to start to glue down these pieces. And I may cut out some more shapes as I go. I may move things as I go, but that's all part of it. It's all part of the journey. So let's get started.